topic, sir. I want to read one small verse, man. It's 2 Timothy 2:13. It says, if we are faithless, he remains faithful, for he cannot deny himself. I know it's small, quick, straight to the point, but it speaks to something that I'm super excited about. But so this Monday, we will be officially launching our residential program here in Tennessee. It has been a long journey for Timothy Hill and organization. It has been a long journey for myself, for my family. So feel with a lot of joy right now, anxious, you know, excitement, figuring out what those days look like ahead. But man, it almost got me speechless, as you can tell. But I think about, man, the whole journey, talking with our CEO outside of the Harlan Library about what that looks like. What does it look like for me to work with Timothy Hill? Because the goal is always to start something in the South, and I had to move up there for a few years. And I mean, I remember getting married, and 8 days later, driving the Penske truck and pulling the U-Haul, and traveling, driving 20 plus hours to New York, and that journey, and all the great people we met, all the challenges we faced, you know, being newlyweds, while in New York, away from all your family. And man, it's been a journey. But God was so faithful in the midst of all of that. And there were times where, you know, I'm like, man, God, what are you doing? But he remains faithful. He remains faithful through it all. And so, man, when I look at that 3-year journey, because that's pretty much what it's been for me, and a 40-year journey really for Timothy Hill to get to this point, 40 plus, man, it's God just being faithful, and being there, being present, being intentional. And so he knew the plans he had. He knows the plans he has for us. And whatever we may be going through in the midst of this time, with finances, with the coronavirus, with the injustices of this world, man, we got to know that we know that we know that God is faithful, that God is in control. I'm having this old school pastor to say, is he is or is he ain't? And that just means, well, who is he to you? And God asked me that question this week, man. Deontay, do you trust me? And that's what it boils down to. If he's in control, then he's in control. And that's how we should live. That's how we should act. Because he has us, and we are his. And if we continue to dwell in him, we know that he's going to take care of us. So, man, I just want to share that exciting news with you all, that we will be launching our first out-of-state program, residential program, down in Tennessee this coming Monday. Please be in prayer. We're getting 5 great young men that we're excited to pour into and help develop. And it's so cool to speak life. I can't wait for those moments where you see something in a guy and you speak that into them. Man, you're a leader. Man, you're a great worker. Man, you're a great encourager. Man, you just bring joy to a room. It happened to me growing up, and that's why I've always felt obligated to give that back. But guys, you don't have to be working in a nonprofit or in the ministry to have those opportunities. Those opportunities can come to you in a grocery store, in a library, in a restaurant, McDonald's, wherever you want to go. Those opportunities are still there. We have to be intentional with our conversations with people, and look for those opportunities to encourage a brother or sister, because you never know what those words of encouragement will do. I remember a quick story I'll say, and then I'll leave you guys be, but I was working at Kids Across America, shout out Kids Across America, and speaking with a young man who was showing great leadership abilities in the cabin. I brought him outside and just one-on-one talking to him. I said, man, I see that in you, man. You're a great leader. I don't know what it is, but man, you running this cabin, you make sure everybody go to bed on time, getting everybody up. That's great leadership skills. Don't let that go. And he looked at me, he said, man, nobody's ever told me that. He said, my dad's gone. Just me, my mom, and my little brothers and sisters, and I take care of them. So that's where it comes from. But I appreciate you just telling me that, because I've never heard that before. And so those opportunities, man, that's priceless. You can't be, you ain't going to schedule that. You ain't going to draw that up. It's not going to be a part of the plan. But we can be intentional with those opportunities once we see something in somebody that reflects a great quality that we want them to know that we see that in them, and that we want them to really explore that avenue. And I expect fully that that young man is a leader in whatever he's doing right now, because that quality was in him and God put that in him. He's placed qualities in every single person watching this video. Now, you have a gift, you have a purpose, you have a mission, and you find your mission, you find your why. I get to experience my why every single day I go to work. We got a young man here now. We get 5 more new man Monday, and I'm super excited to pour and speak life into them, to motivate them and to build them up as young men, better men for this world, but ultimately great warriors for the kingdom as well. Man, so you guys continue to pray for us as we go on this journey. Timothy Hill, and we're definitely in prayer for you all. We love you guys, and if you remember my rope story, I'm still pulling. I'm pulling. If you've ever overcame anything in your life that God has blessed you with, I think we all are obligated to reach back and pull those behind us that are struggling with that same very thing. So get your rope. I got my rope. I pull my rope every day I leave my house, because I remind myself to keep pulling. Even when the day gets hard, when things get stressful, you gotta keep pulling. We love you guys. Thank you so much for listening. Y'all be blessed.